Dark Seduction is the greatest midnight movie of all time. It took 30 years to finish this film. Only took 2 weeks to shoot it, but 30 years to finish it because, you know, it got lost. There was so many problems. It was cursed. We had to have the curse lifted. It was crazy to get the film finished. It's finally finished in 2016, shot in 1984, and here it is. The midnight premiere of the greatest midnight movie of all time, Dark Seduction. I'm so excited to be here at the New Art Theater, which is the theater that the first midnight movie was shown at, which was Rocky Horror Picture Show in 1975. Then came Pink Flamingos, and then came Eraserhead in 1977. And that's what I saw here, and that's what made me want to make a midnight movie.
Greg and I worked together in Dallas, and... And he probably thought to himself, can I curse? Probably thought to himself, what an asshole. He'd be perfect for this.
I play Laura, who the lead is, I'm his ex-girlfriend. And he's kind of been drinking too much, and I left him, and I hooked up with this guy that is very wealthy, I would say, is his redeeming quality. But he's not very nice to me. So when he comes to find me and sees who I'm living with, I let him know that I left because he was drinking too much. It's a very classic film noir, but it's mixed with vampires. Yeah, it's a genre blend.
I'm known as Ricardo King. I'm the king in the production of Dark Seduction. It's amazing. The backstory behind Dark Seduction is incredible. I never thought that we would get here, but we're here now. And it's such a pleasure to be here with everyone, with Greg and the whole production staff and crew and everything. I would see Greg from time to time in the process of the production, and we get a chance to talk and discuss it and talk about the lost years, because it has been a few.
Hi, I'm Rick Overton, and I play the punk ninja. There's two punks in there, and Lou Roth is the other one, but I'm the ninja punk. And I'm the deadliest thing I've ever heard of until I run into, well, someone else. To find out that it was all ready to roll and for everyone to see after all the fun we had and work we put into it and stuff like that, I just thought someone should get a laugh out of this. It's so much fun.
Hi, I'm Andy Dick.
My name's Jeff Michalski.
We are friends of the film. Let's put it that way.
That's right. Very good friends of the film.
Yeah. We've known the film since 1984.
Used to be our roommate. But the film hasn't paid its rent for a while,
yeah,
so.
Yeah. So hopefully people pay for their tickets tonight because there is some back rent due to both of us.
Yes.
Basically, this movie owes us a lot.
But we're still supportive.
We have a lot of friends in it. Paul Henderson, are you in this movie? Are you in this movie? This is the guy that told me.
Hey, how you doing?
How's it go? Introduced me to the movie. You guys know that the movie started. Do you guys know that the movie started in what, 1984?
84. They shot it during the Olympics.
Oh, and they just finished it now, and not because it's some kind of artistic experiment, but because they just didn't have the money.
When this movie was made, I was just 300 pounds. That's how long ago.
My name's Steve Bishart, and I produced it and shot it and wrote it, and here we are. The best thing I can tell you is this all started. I woke up one day after film school. I realized I was turning into a bum. I didn't know what to do. I spent my last money on my credit card on a couple beers. And then I said, I got to do something. Okay, I got a degree in filmmaking. I'll make a movie. So I wrote I walked down Hollywood Boulevard. I touched every star on the sidewalk. Almost got killed on the way back. I was weak in the knees, and I came back, and I wrote the script, and I realized it would be too dark and stuff if I did it just my way, and I had been working with Greg. So I said, hey, Greg, you know, why don't you come by and write a couple jokes for this thing? You know, it would be really good, you know, and perfect for Greg and I to, you know, my spooky trip that's all gloom and doom, and then Greg's whimsy, you know, and plus Greg had this kick-ass style, and, you know, I knew it needed some of that.
This is John Kassir, Major Film Events. And I'm actually not hosting, but I feel like I am. I've come for a good time. I'm a huge fan of Greg Travis, the writer-director. And back in the day, in the mid-'80s, when I came up through the ranks winning Star Search as a stand-up comedian, little-known fact, yes. And Greg was on the scene at that time, and we used to hang out at the Improv. And Greg lived right around the corner from the Improv, and he used to get a bunch of us together and say, hey, I got these really fun short movies that I've made. Come see him at my apartment. And we would pack his apartment with all these crazy people and laugh our asses off. And so I've been a fan of Greg's for many years, so I can't wait to see what he's done with a full-length feature budget and a lot of great actors and some funny material.
I'm here to support the film, anything with blood and murder. At this time of night, I'm really all about that. And I'm hoping to get some new tips. Killing. Specifically killing.
My name is Ken Gibbel. I played Los Angeles Police Department homicide detective Sergeant Murdoch, best friend of Dick Jones, our hero. I never lost confidence in over 30 years since I shot my original scenes, my part. And when he finished it, I couldn't have been happier, because in my file cabinet at home, in a labeled folder, all by itself is the original SAG contract.
Gabriel, Jarret, and I'm actually not in this film, although I would like to be, because frankly, these teeth right here, mine were actually filed down when I was younger, and unfortunately I had an orthodontist that didn't understand Nosferatu. And so I ended up with just regular teeth, and I miss it, so I'm here longing for the olden days. I'm here to support, of course. Are you kidding? And I love anything Dracula, vampire, Nosferatu, you name it, I love it. And so, you know, I feel like I'm amongst friends.